Welcome to one more video. We had seen the article type creation, and to create an article we need basically three things. One is the article type, one is the merchandise category, and a vendor. All the other things are already predefined in the system. So we had seen about the article type creation. We will move on to the next major criteria, that is the merchandise category. So to create a merchandise category, we need few more things like characteristics. So we will start off with the characteristics. So what is a characteristic? Characteristic is nothing but the attribute of a material or person of something. It's like so the attributes could be of anything, physical, intangible, anything. But when we come into the materials, we are going to talk about the physical characteristics of the material, and we are going to define them in the system and use them in our material creation. We need the characteristics basically for the variant articles. For example, let us say like you have a shirt. When we go to the shop, we are seeing the shirts, but we are seeing the shirts in different colors, different sizes. Okay, but at the end of the day, everything is a shirt. How it is varied? It is varied different based on the size and the color. Okay, so as per SAP, the shirt is a single article. Okay, but the shirts of different colors and different sizes are its own variants. So it's enough to create one single material for this shirt along with the variant. System will automatically assign the variants. Similarly, for any readers, you can identify between the paperback and the hardbound edition. Okay, so whomever travels, they prefer the paperback edition, because paperback editions are very simple, very lightweight. Okay, paper of not so good quality and a lighter cover, so which can even bend across when you thrust it along with your luggage and other things. So you can read it and you can throw it off. Okay, but for something you want to store in your library, you might want to have a proper bound book with a thick hard covers and long illustrated and very good glossy shiny paper, and those kind of. So the book is the same, one single article, but you have different variants based on the illustrations as well as the cover. Okay, so in Core SD, we will not be able to maintain these variants. So in Core SD, for example, if a shirt has four different colors and four different sizes, you can create a matrix of 16 possible variants. Okay, in SD you have to create 16 materials for the shirt. Okay, whereas in retail you can create one material with 16 variant. The system will automatically assign all those variant numbers by suffixing it with 001002. Okay, so to create these variant articles, you will need the characteristics. So how to create a characteristics? So I think I'm using the word so very much. Characteristics management. So here you are going to define just the characteristics. So this characteristics color is something I intend to use for the apparels. Okay, and what is its format? Its format is the characteristics. It can have single value in one article. Okay, there will be 18 characters. You can maintain the descriptions in various languages. If you want, you can assign the character values here. Okay, the system will pick it up. However, I prefer not to assign here, because when you have very large number of characteristics values, but you might want to group them, subgroup them. For example, like you subgroup them based on, say, like these are the colors I want to use it for women wear, these are the colors I use it for kids wear, these are all the colors I use for men's formal. You can group them at a later point of time. So I'm not maintaining anything here. Instead, I'm going to use the functional module to store the characteristics. Similarly, I want to create another characteristics called as size. So what I had did, I had basically defined the characteristics, okay, but I hadn't defined what kind of characteristic it is or what its value is. Okay, so I can go to, I'm going to assign the or create the values for that process characteristics values. So www So here I have to say what kind of characteristics it is. It's a color characteristics. So color characteristics is something that is pre-shipped with the SAP Retail. Other than anything other than that, for example, I told you an example of a book with hardbound cover and a paperback cover. That is not shipped. So if you are creating such characteristics, you can mark it as character type not typed and proceed with that. Since this is a color, I'm going to say it as color characteristics. And this checking is when you're creating the material master, it will look into the characteristic maintenance and give the error or warning accordingly. It is saying similar characteristics already exist. Why you want to create a new one, or you can take the value from there. So I ignore it. So I'm saying my characteristics value is, first I'll put it as WH white. Then what else we can? I'm copying the same thing. Size. This is a side. Yes. Let me put one more L. Okay. I'm not maintaining the European sizes, so just let me save it. Now you can group this. Okay. Basically, why you want to group? If you are going to create a kids material, so you might not need the extra large sizes there. Okay, you might need from extra small to medium. When you are creating for the adults, you might not need extra small. You might start from medium to extra large sizes. Okay, so you can group them and use them in your material master creation. So www color. I'm going to group them one based on the first group. I hadn't seen any men wearing yellow color for the formals, so I don't want to use the yellow for my men's formal range of things. Similarly, once you create it, you choose the characteristics values. Black, yes, blue is also possible. I don't see anybody wearing a green, so no red. Okay, so I had chosen 3. Okay. I can create a new group. So black, blue, green, red, white, yellow. Beach wears. So for beach you can wear all colors. So I'm going to select everything for the beach wears. So I have grouped these things. Okay. Now I had defined my characteristics. I had grouped my characteristics according to my requirement. Now I have to create a merchandise category and assign these characteristics to that. Okay, so we'll go to that later. Okay, because the characteristics can have different values and you can maintain them either at the characteristics level itself, or you can create something called as characteristics profile and assign them. Else you can assign these characteristics in a grouped and assigned to the merchandise category. Okay, to sum it up, first values maintained directly in the characteristics, second else values grouped together and using functional module, that is what we saw right now. And third is one more, you have something called as characteristics profile. So you'll see the characteristics profile management. You come here, characteristics profile. So I'm going to use one characteristics profile for the casuals. Okay, all those care profile. Okay, so what is my WW color? WW size. Okay, so whether these characteristics should influence your variant creation or not, that is controlled by here. If you don't put it as, if you don't maintain it here, if you don't maintain it here, it is just for information. It will not influence your variant creation. Okay. If you had marked it as 2, you will be able to create a variant based on that. If you had marked it used 3, it is used as a logistics unit of measure. I want to create variant based on that, so I am using 2. So that's all about the characteristics maintenance. In the next video, we will see about creating the merchandise category and assigning these things, all these three types. One is the direct characteristics assignment, one through the characteristics profile, and one through these grouped values, and create an article based on that. Bye.